गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
या इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट प्लीज टेल मी।
सर लेवल टू क्लास वर्क फिफ्थ
फोर्थ सर सेवन
Level 2 classwork, 4th.
Yeah.
And also 5th.
Okay. The car is moving along a straight line, say OP and figure. It moves from O to P in 18 seconds and returns from P to Q in 6 seconds. What is the average velocity and average speed of the car going from O to P and back to Q? So if you are finding out the value of average velocity, yeah, bolo beta.
Level 2 mein.
Sir, level 2.
Okay, ye nahi hai. Sorry, ye level 1 hai. Sorry, sir. Level 2, 4, right? Yeah. Say man works on a straight road from his home to market 2.5 km away with a speed of 5 km per hour. Finding that the market is closed, he instantly turns and walks back home with a speed of 7.5 km per hour. What is the magnitude of average velocity? So I think that is clear that average velocity is zero.
Yes, sir.
Because it is starting from a point and coming back to same point. So total displacement is equal to zero. So we can say that average velocity is equal to zero. I think that's clear, right?
Yes, sir.
And average speed of man over the entire, for the time interval from 0 to 50 minutes is, okay. So our aim is to find out the average speed of man. So over here, you can observe that distance traveled in the first situation and second situation is same.
Yes.
So if distance traveled is same, then for the calculation of average velocity, we'll use that equation 2 divided by 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2. Yeah, there?
Yes, sir.
Or you can use that equation 2 V1 V2 divided by V1 plus V2 when the distance is same. Right?
Yeah.
So we can go for 2.5 and or kya tha 7.5 sorry 5 and 7.5 so 2 into 5 into 7.5 divided by 5 plus 7.5 right or
sir see
A starts from rest and moves with an acceleration of A1. 2 seconds later, B starts from rest and moves with an acceleration of A2. If the displacement of A in the 5th second is same as that of B in the same interval, then the ratio of A1 is to A2 is. It is given that A starts from rest. So we can just consider that we are having an object, let's say A. It is starting from rest. So at t is equal to zero, its velocity is equal to zero. And moves with an acceleration of A1. And it is moving with an acceleration of A1. 2 seconds later, so B start ho gaya 2 seconds ke baad. So we can just consider that when time is equal to 2 seconds, then B start kiya. Okay. So 2 seconds later, B starts from rest and moves with an acceleration of A2. And this is moving with an acceleration of A2. If the displacement of A in the 5th second, you know that what is displacement in 5th second? Displacement of 5th second is nothing but distance traveled when a time of t is equal to 4 seconds to 5 seconds. 4 seconds se leke 5 seconds ka beech mein jo distance travel karega, which is nothing but displacement in the 5th second. So displacement in 5th second is nothing but the distance traveled by the particle in between time interval 4 to 5. Now, if the displacement of A in 5th second is same as that of B in the same interval, is same as that of B in the same interval. So आप देखो A के लिए fourth second, B के लिए कौन सा time आएगा? सोच के बोलो.
2 second.
ये इसका 2 second आएगा ना? समझा? Because B A start करने के बाद 2 second के बाद start किया. तो इसका T का 0 जैसा consider करें तो ये क्या हो गया, इसके लिए 2 second ही हुआ. तो ये क्या हो गया, 2 to 3 का बीच में कितना डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल कर रहा है वो फाइंड आउट करना है. तो ये हो गया डिस्प्लेसमेंट इन दी थर्ड सेकंड. सो द रेशियो ऑफ A1 इज टू A2s. सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ फर्स्ट वन इन दी फिफ्थ सेकंड इज इक्वल टू, वी कैन टेक इट एज u प्लस a इनटू n माइनस हाफ is equal to displacement of second one in the third second. That is u plus a into u plus a2 into n minus half. Right? Now we can equate this one. Both are having an initial velocity which is equal to 0 and only time is different. So we can write it as this a1 into n, we can take it as nothing but fifth second. So 5 minus half is equal to nothing but a2 into 3 minus half. So thus we can take it as a1 and 2. This will be equal to 1.5 or 9 divided by 2, which is equal to a2 into 5 divided by 2. So we can cancel this.
हाँ हाँ मस्ती कर रहे हैं, प्लीज आप बताइए अभी.
सर रिमूव दोस पार्टिसिपेंट्स जार सर, दोस हु डोंट हैव द सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन रिमूव फ्रॉम द मीटिंग, वी डोंट वांट सच स्टूडेंट्स.
सर सर
सर सबको वीडियो ऑन करने के लिए बताना सर, लेट्स सी व्हाट दे आर डूइंग.
But if there is any background noise or something, please आप उसका mic को mute करके रखो, okay? और properly class को attend करो.
Okay sir.
एक बार सब लोग video on करना बेटा, सब लोग video on करना. The next 5 minutes we'll see what you're doing. Video on करना, make it fast.
Okay, so you'll get the answer. RM is to find out the ratio of A1 to A2. No, I think we'll get the value of A1 by A2 is equal to,
yes, you got it,
5
got
divided it. By 9. Yeah. Or any other questions?
Sir, 6th also.
6th one. 6th one is given that a body travels 200 centimeter in the first 2 seconds and 220 centimeter in the next 4 seconds with a deceleration. The velocity of body at the end of 7th second is. So we can just draw the situation. A body travels 200 centimeter in first 2 seconds. So take it as at t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, an object is starting from here. And at travel a distance of 200 centimeter in first 2 seconds. So when time is equal to 2 seconds, it reaches somewhere over here, traveling a distance of 200 centimeter. And 220 centimeter in the next 4 seconds. So next 4 seconds means when time is equal to 6 seconds, it is 2 to 6, it is traveling a distance of 220 centimeter. Next 4 seconds with a deceleration, the velocity of body at the end of 7 seconds is. RM is to find out what about the value of velocity when time is equal to 7 seconds. When t is equal to 7, find out its velocity. So that is represented by v over here. So we can write what about the value of its acceleration and or initial velocity in from these two informations. Like if you are considering the first case from 0 to 2 seconds, a body travels 200 meters in the first 2 seconds. So we can just consider that its initial velocity is equal to u. We don't know the value for that. And it is moving with some deceleration. So we can just take it as something but minus a, its acceleration. And distance traveled is equal to 200 centimeter. And time taken over here is something but 2 seconds. So this we can take it as something but our first situation. Now, in second case, we can write the equation as something but either up 0 to 6, x click sector directly. Okay. So if I'm writing directly from 0 to 6 seconds, so initial velocity we'll take it as u, acceleration we'll take it as minus a, displacement we'll take it as something but 420 centimeter.
अच्छा, from 0 to 6. Deceleration दोनों केस के लिए था क्या?
हाँ, मतलब overall always this particle is moving with the same deceleration from 0 to 2, 2 to 6 or 7. So that acceleration is constant or yeah, deceleration is constant, minus a only.
Hmm.
Then we can write its time taken. We'll take it as from 0 to 6, that is 6. So over here you can write one equation, s is equal to ut plus half a t square. And here also we can use the same equation, s is equal to ut plus half a t square. So we are having two equations and two unknowns. So we'll get the value of u and v. Yeah. U and a. Once we got the value of u and a, we can find out the value of v by using this equation. V is equal to u plus a t. This may u plus a into t ka value kya 7 second mein chahiye tha, toh 7 put karo. Samajh mein aaya baat?
Yes.
तो बेसिकली आपको ये इक्वेशन लिखना आना चाहिए, बाद में जस्ट कैलकुलेशन ही है।
सर वो मुझे लगा वो सिर्फ 220 पे डिसेलरेशन।
नहीं नहीं नहीं, जीरो स्टार्टिंग से लेके डिसेलरेशन करके आ रहा था वो।
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
और
सर
minus half into a into t square, that we can take it as 4. Okay. And for this one, we can take it as 420 is equal to u into 6 minus half into a into 36. Okay. So we can write 200 is equal to 2u minus 2a. Or you can write 420 is equal to 6u minus 18a. तो आप इसको मतलब arrange करके लिख सकता है, and think rest of the thing you know that ना आप चाहिए तो 100 is equal to u minus a लिख सकता है, इसको आप 6 से divide कर सकता है, तो क्या आएगा 70 is equal to u minus 3a आएगा. अब इसको सॉल्व करना तो आता है ना बेटा?
Sir,
is the answer 15? Yeah, देख लो, मतलब sixth का ना?
Yeah.
Six का 3. हाँ भाई, six का 10 आ रहा शायद, देख लो.
10, okay.
Negative sign put किया है का?
नहीं शायद. I need to check.
ये negative है ना? Acceleration negative है ना?
Yeah.
So the seventh one, same mm-hmm. column. I'm not getting the answer like right. Can you please mm-hmm. solve it?
A bullet moves 20 meter per second. It strikes a wooden plank and penetrates 4 centimeter before coming to stop. The time taken to stop is. So what are the informations given as? One is its initial velocity, which is 20. And final velocity, which is 0, because it is coming to rest. And it strikes a wooden plank and penetrates 4 centimeter. And distance is given as nothing but 4 centimeter. So over there, first velocity is given in meter. So 4 centimeter, we can take it as 0.04 meter. Got it? And the time taken is, RM is to find out the value of T. So we can use, first we need to find out the value of acceleration by using V square minus U square is equal to 2s. First we can find out V square minus U square is equal to 2s. From that we can find out the value of A. Once you got the value of acceleration, then we can use that equation, S is equal to UT plus, V is equal to U plus AT. Anavada?
Yeah.
So you are not getting the answer.
Yes, I'll just solve it once more.
Okay, you will try kardo.
Sir, can you solve the sixth? I'm getting U is equal to 150.
Yes, sir. Hmm. Sir, in both the cases, the U value is coming different. If we put in U minus A, then it is coming 85, and U minus 3, it is coming different. In 6th one.
No, samjhane, but you're saying about this question?
Yes, yes sir.
Hmm. What happened?
Acceleration came minus 15.
Yeah, first we can find out the value of this acceleration. Let's say if you are going for equation number, let's say it is 2 and equation number 1. If you are going for equation number 2 minus equation number 1, 100 minus 70, we can take it as 30 is equal to this U and U get cancelled. Minus A plus 3A, which we can take it as 2A. So A will be equal to 15. So acceleration ka value, we should take it as minus 15. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. The acceleration is minus 15. Now we can find out the value of velocity. So in this equation, if I'm putting the value of 100 is equal to nothing but U
plus 50.
U plus U minus U plus A, 100 plus A is equal to nothing but U. So the value of this U is going to be 100. Minus A is minus 15. Got it. So the value of initial velocity, you should take it as 85. Got it. Now if you are putting this value over here, it is going to be 85 plus acceleration was minus 15, right? So we can take it as minus 15 into 7. Minus 15 into 7. So iska value kya aega? 85 minus minus 105. Five.
Sir, if we put the value of acceleration in equation number 1, then U is coming different.
And U is coming different?
Yes, sir. If we put in equation 1.
Sir, aapne pehle minus A likha hai, fir wapas minus 15 ko.
क्या बोला बेटा
सर आपने पहले ही माइनस मतलब यूटी प्लस हाफ एटी प्लस होता है तो आपने माइनस लिखा है तो वापस आप माइनस 15 क्यों कर रहे हैं गलत अरे तो सर ने स्टार्टिंग में यूटी माइनस
ओके ओके आई का वैल्यू प्लस 15 ही पुट करना है ऐसे
हां
यू का वैल्यू तो प्लस 15 है 1105 आएगा 1115 आएगा गाइस
हां सर उससे भी नहीं है उससे
तो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू क्या आएगा U ka value 115 minus 105. So 10 aayega na iska value.
Correct, sir. Yes, sir.
ऑलरेडी इसको हमने डिसेलरेशन कंसीडर करके नेगेटिव साइन पुट किया था यार, फिर से नेगेटिव लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है। बोलो बेटा,
लेवल 2 क्लास वर्क क्वेश्चन 8 एंड 9।
लेवल 2 क्लास वर्क क्वेश्चन 8 एंड 9।
यस सर।
An automobile is traveling with a speed of 60 km per hour can brake to stop with a distance of 20 meter. If the car is going twice fast as 120 km per hour, the stopping distance will be. So initially it was moving with a speed of 60. Now its speed is increased to 120. So actually we are increasing speed by 2 times, so we can find out what about the value of what happened to stopping distance. Okay, so for calculation purpose, we can just imagine that initially, if its velocity was u, when it is coming to rest, its velocity v is going to be zero. Distance traveled is taken as s, and deceleration is taken as anything but a or minus of a. So if we are writing the equation, so we can write v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Final velocity is zero, initial velocity is u, acceleration is minus a, and displacement is taken as s. So we can write the relation between them is u square is equal to 2 into a into s, or we can write in both the cases the deceleration provided by the brake is same. That means this u square is directly proportional to s. So u square is directly proportional to s, or we can write s is directly proportional to u square. That means if you are increasing the value of u by 2 times, s is going to increase by square of this.
Square of.
So 2 ka square kya aega? 4 aega.
4.
So the distance is going to increase by 4 times. Like if velocity is increased by 3 times, distance is going to increase by 9 times. Like that. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
The ninth
sir.
Also.
Yeah. A police body is moving in a jeep at a constant speed of v. They saw a thief at a distance x on a motorcycle, which is at rest. The moment the police saw the thief starts at a constant acceleration alpha. Which of the following relation is true if the police is able to catch the thief? So, a situation mein a bata raha ki consider that there is a police car over here and it is moving with a constant velocity v. And a thief was over here and which was at a distance x with respect to this police car. And this thief will start with an initial velocity of zero. But moving with an acceleration which is given as anything but alpha. Now in question it is given that the moment police saw the thief started constant acceleration. Which of the following relation is true if the police is able to catch the thief? So the police is able to catch the thief means agar maan lo from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t, agar t time mein thief idhar tak aa gaya, same time mein पुलिस भी अगर इतना डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल करके आ सकता है तो ये थीफ को पकड़ सकता है, राइट? सो वी कैन से दैट दिस फ्रॉम t इज इक्वल टू 0 टू t इज इक्वल टू t, दिस शुड बी द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ दैट पुलिस, लेट्स से आई एम जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटिंग बाय sp, एंड सेम टाइम में दिस इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ दैट थीफ। सो पुलिस इसको कैच कर सकता है if displacement of police is greater than or equal to that of x plus st. Samjha? Agar utna nahi aa payega to usko catch nahi karega, matlab thief aage nikal jayega. So we can write the relation between them, and displacement of this police is nothing but displacement we can take as velocity into time. Velocity is v and time we can take as nothing but t, v into t. Should be greater than or equal to that of x. X plus displacement of this thief, which you can use that equation s is equal to ut plus half at square. Ut plus half at square. So u is equal to 0. That is half into acceleration is given as nothing but alpha. into t square, which we can take it as anything, but let's say this t square. So this will be the over here it is. हमने time के सबसे लिखा, but जो भी answer में दिया, which is given with respect to velocity. Okay, so we can write the same thing with respect to velocity. If you'd like to write the same thing with respect to velocity, means what we'll write is the velocity of this one increased to a value, let's say that is equal to v. अगर thief का speed police का speed से भी ज़्यादा हो गया, तो भी catch नहीं कर पाएगा. तो answer में डिस्टेंस के हिसाब सॉरी टाइम के हिसाब से नहीं दिया है, बट इट इज अब ऑप्शन में देखो वेलोसिटी के हिसाब से दिया है. तो वी कैन राइट द सेम थिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वेलोसिटी, दैट इज व्हाट अबाउट द वेलोसिटी अटेन्ड बाय दिस थीफ, दैट इज वी इज इक्वल टू, वी कैन राइट दैट वेलोसिटी अटेन्ड बाय दैट थीफ इन अ टाइम टी, v is equal to, if you are using that equation, u plus at. So this v can be written as nothing but initial velocity, we can take it as zero, and a can be written as nothing but alpha and time we can take it as nothing but t over here. Got it? ताकि आप t का value v का value में convert करके लिख सकता है, समझा? अगर उसका value इससे ज़्यादा हो गया, तो उसको catch नहीं कर पाएगा. और actually ये question, yeah. एक्चुअली क्वेश्चन रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी यूज करके हम लोग करता है, ठीक है, तो वो आपको ज्यादा समझ में आएगा. मैं सपोज हमने थीफ को अरेस्ट पे मान के इसको करना चाहिए एक्चुअली, तभी आपको उसका एग्जैक्ट आइडिया मिलेगा.
कैन यू एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन?
या एक्चुअली ये दो ऑब्जेक्ट मूव कर रहा है ना, तो हम लोग बेसिकली क्या करता है, कंसेप्ट ऑफ रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी यूज करता है. तो आप एक क्वेश्चन को मार्क करके रखो, रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी के सबसे समझाता हूँ, देन यू विल गेट अ बेटर आइडिया अबाउट दिस.
Okay.
Because दोनों मूव कर रहे हैं एक साथ, मतलब अगर आप थीफ का मतलब आपको समझ, I'm not necessary that you'll come to know, understand that, कि अगर कार ये थीफ का फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस में देखे तो वो इसका भी स्पीड, दोनों का स्पीड जब जीरो होगा तभी उसको कैच कर सकता है, ऐसा सिचुएशन है, वो रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी में आता है. We'll discuss it, अब मार्क कर कर रखो, we'll discuss it after relative velocity.
So question number 11.
Certain.
एक मिनट. Actually, exam के लिए एक ग्राफ का एक टॉपिक करना है. फर्स्ट हमने वो ग्राफ का टॉपिक करता, फिर इसका डाउट्स आगे कंटिन्यू करता. ओके, सो वी डिस्कस अबाउट दिस ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मोशन. सो जस्ट राइट ऑन द हेडिंग, ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मोशन. Graphical representation of motion. सब लोग ऑलरेडी पढ़ा होगा ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मोशन में, लाइक डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ, वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ, एक्सीलरेशन टाइम ग्राफ एक्सेट्रा.
हाँ सर.
तो फर्स्ट पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू एनालाइज अ ग्राफ. तो कोई भी ग्राफ है वो हम लोग उसको ग्राफ को ऐसा देख के कुछ आंसर नहीं लिखना है, मतलब अगर आपको कुछ displacement time graph दिया है and it is on something like this, तो हम लोग इसको देख के ऐसा नहीं देखना है कि टाइम बढ़ रहा है तो डिस्प्लेसमेंट बढ़ रहा है, ठीक है? ऐसा वो ग्राफ का शेप देख के हम लोग इसको एनालाइज नहीं करता है, मतलब ऑब्जर्व करके हमने इक्वेशन नहीं लिखता है, ग्राफ को एनालाइज करके इक्वेशन मतलब आंसर लिखना है। अभी ग्राफ को कैसे एनालाइज करना है तो ऑलरेडी हमने डिस्कस किया था, तो मतलब हमने दो पॉइंट डिस्कस किया था ग्राफ के बेसिस में। एक पॉइंट था स्लोप ऑफ अ ग्राफ, I think you might be remembering that. Slope kya tha? What was slope?
Tan theta dy by
dx. Dy by dx or tan theta. Or slope humne find out kar raha tha while just drawing a horizontal over here. And what about the value of angle made by this horizontal with respect to this line? Isko humne or tangential line. Isko humne theta likha tha. Yaad hai?
Yes sir.
So then we wrote the value of this tan theta is equal to nothing but dy divided by dx. Agar if it is a graph between y and x, right? So one concept we'll use over here is nothing but slope, and we'll write slope is equal to tan theta is equal to dy by dx. Ye har ek graph mein, not only kinematics ka graph hai, matlab physics mein bahut sare situation mein graph aayega. हर एक ग्राफ को हमने यही कंसेप्ट यूज करके एनालाइज करेगा, ठीक है? कल इतना ही देखना है स्लोप क्या है उसका और वो स्लोप क्या रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है। सेकंड थिंग है आपको फाइंड आउट करना है वेदर द स्लोप इज पॉजिटिव और वेदर द स्लोप इज नेगेटिव। तो हमने ऑलरेडी डिस्कस किया था स्लोप पॉजिटिव कब होता है या टैन थीटा पॉजिटिव कब होता है और टैन थीटा नेगेटिव कब होता है। सो टैन थीटा पॉजिटिव कब होता है?
थर्ड क्वार्टर।
When the value of theta is
less than 90.
First quarter, na? All thetas are positive in the first quarter. Yes. So tan theta is positive when theta is less than 90 degree.
In the third and quadrant also.
Sir, in an increasing slope, it is positive.
Yeah. So theta ke sabse humne bolte ki when it is less than 90, aap third quadrant dekhne ka zarurat nahi hai because जो स्लोप में जो थीटा का वैल्यू मैक्सिमम 180 तक ही होता है ना, उसके ऊपर नहीं आता है।
या
सो इफ इट इज ग्रेटर देन 90 देन स्लोप इज नेगेटिव एंड इफ इट इज लेस देन 90 देन स्लोप इज पॉजिटिव और टैन थीटा इज पॉजिटिव लाइक दैट। ओके सो वी नीड टू ऑब्जर्व व्हाट अबाउट द वैल्यू ऑफ स्लोप एंड वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द स्लोप इज पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव और यू कैन राइट टैन थीटा इज नेगेटिव व्हेन थीटा इज ग्रेटर देन 90। तो इवन we'll just draw a graph for that. A case mein theta ka value 90 se zyada hai, toh slope ka value negative ho gaya. Is it clear? Okay. Toh humne ek concept use karke graph ko pehle observe karenge. Phir humne ek aur concept use kiya tha, that is area under the graph karke. Theek hai? Toh dono ek saath kare toh aap confuse ho jayega. Toh pehle aap kali slope of graph hi dekho. Area ka use kahan karna hai, that we'll discuss. Okay. So first we are going to discuss about a displacement time graph. First hum log discuss kar rahe displacement time graph. So write down the heading displacement time graph or on bracket you can write ST graph. Displacement time graph or ST graph. Okay. So in displacement time graph, suppose if you are having displacement along y-axis and time is along x-axis. And we are going to draw different type of graph over here. And we need to identify basically what this graph is representing. So before we are starting with displacement time graph, if in case of displacement time graph, if I am finding out the value of slope, what will be the value for it?
tan theta.
Tan theta ka value kya aega?
ds by dt.
Yes. Because normal y or x ka graph tha, to tan theta kya tha? dy by dx tha na. To displacement or time ka graph hai, to tan theta kya hoga? ds by dt hoga.
Yeah.
To bolo, what is ds by dt?
Velocity.
Very good. So basically, slope of displacement time graph is representing the value of velocity. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, अभी आप पूरा graph को displacement time graph को only एक concept use करके analyze करना है, what about the value of its slope, whether it is positive or negative, okay? And slope of displacement time graph represents velocity, okay?
Yeah.
Now, just a likh do, a part likh do, and displacement time graph, this slope represents or tan theta represents ds by dt, which is equal to velocity.
So I have a doubt.
Yeah, bolo.
So I've always seen that when it comes to displacement time graph, s is on the y-axis and t is on the x-axis.
Yes.
On what basis is this convention set, and what happens if we reverse this?
No, nothing will happen. Like, the way we are drawing the graph will change. Like, अगर आप इसको s y और x में भी x मतलब sorry s और x axis में t y axis में draw कर सकता है, कुछ problem नहीं है. अगर हमने इसको draw करेगा तो क्या होता है कि हमने जो लिखा है वो उल्टा हो जाएगा. अगर मैंने time इधर लिखा है और displacement इधर लिखा है, and अगर मैंने slope find out करेगा, then I'll get the value of tan theta which is dt divided by ds. That is reciprocal of velocity मिलेगा बस.
Okay. Okay sir.
स्लोप का रेसिप्रोकल मिलेगा अगर आप मतलब एक इसके सबसे मतलब वाई को एक्स में रखे तो क्या चेंजेस होगा उतना ही.
ठीक है. ओके
सर. नॉर्मली हम लोग जो भी ग्राफ देता है लाइक डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ, वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ, एक्सेलरेशन टाइम ग्राफ एक्सेट्रा, ये सब केस में जो टाइम है वो एक्स एक्सिस में लेता है और
okay.
बाकी सब वेरिएबल है वो वाई एक्सिस में लेता है.
ओके सर, थैंक यू.
Now we'll discuss about what are the different possible type of displacement time graph that may they ask in different questions. So first, I'm just considering the graph something like this. जो graph है वो ऐसा है, ठीक है? Time axis से मतलब x axis से मैंने एक straight line draw किया like this. तभी बोलो what this graph represents?
Velocity.
Velocity.
There is no increase in displacement.
Zero acceleration.
There is no displacement or
velocity is zero.
So it can be also said that the object is moving in a circle. Because if it moves in a circle,
no.
Object is stationary.
Object is at rest. Very good. ठीक है? तभी देखो, हमने पहले बोला कि आप एक ग्राफ को देखना नहीं है, मतलब ग्राफ को ऑब्जर्व करना है, मतलब ग्राफ को एनालाइज करना है, not just by looking this graph, you should not take any conclusions. तो ग्राफ को देखने के लिए हमारे पास ज्यादा कुछ भी नहीं है. You just observe what about the value of slope over here. तो पहले देखना है ये केस में इसका स्लोप एंगल का थीटा का वैल्यू क्या है.
180
या 0.
180
सेम है ना. अगर हमें स्लोप थीटा का वैल्यू क्या हो गया, 0 हो गया. थीटा 0 है तो टैन थीटा का वैल्यू क्या रहेगा,
0. नेगेटिव
0. टैन 0 इज 0. तो स्लोप ऑफ दिस ग्राफ, स्लोप ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ग्राफ इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग वेलोसिटी. तो ये क्या रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, वेलोसिटी इज इक्वल टू
0.
So we can say that this graph represents that particle is at rest. Okay. तो मैंने दूसरा graph draw कर रहा हूँ. Let's say over here. बोलो ये जो graph है ये क्या represent कर रहा
है? Sir, uniform velocity.
So stationary.
Uniform velocity, uniform displacement, uniform acceleration.
Sir, after some motion, the object is now stationary.
Stationary, okay.
Okay. Listen, again, आप बहुत सारा चीज़ observe कर रहे हैं. What I'm saying is, not need to do any more calculations. Not need to do anything. आप क्या देखना है? Just identify what about the slope of this curve. बोलो इसका slope क्या है?
Zero.
तो वेलोसिटी क्या हो गया?
Zero.
तो दिस ग्राफ इज आल्सो रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट पार्टिकल इज एट रेस्ट एंड दिस वन इज आल्सो रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट पार्टिकल इज एट रेस्ट. आई एम जस्ट ड्राइंग अ ग्राफ ओवर हियर. बोलो ये क्या रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है? ठीक है, तो आप खाली स्लोप को देखना है और कुछ भी मत देखना है, ठीक है?
Okay.
अभी देखो इसमें डिफरेंस क्या है, अभी देखते हैं हमने तीन ग्राफ में डिफरेंस क्या है। हमने इतना ही बोला कि सब केस में वेलोसिटी तो जीरो है, इसमें डिफरेंस क्या इतना है, ये जो पार्टिकल है ये रेस्ट पे है बट ओरिजिन पे है, दूसरा एक पार्टिकल है वो रेस्ट पे है बट थोड़ा पॉजिटिव साइड पे है, ये पार्टिकल है वो रेस्ट पे है बट ओरिजिन से थोड़ा नेगेटिव साइड पे है। समझा? मतलब अगर आप एक एक्स वाई कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम कंसिडर कर रहा है, इसको हमने ओरिजिन कंसिडर किया है, अज्यूम दैट देयर इज अ पार्टिकल ए व्हिच इज रेस्ट एट ओरिजिन एंड देयर इज अनदर पार्टिकल बी व्हिच इज एट रेस्ट बट हैविंग सम पॉजिटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड देयर इज अ पार्टिकल सी व्हिच इज हैविंग सम नेगेटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट, समझा? बट ए बी एंड सी आर एट रेस्ट, समझा? बेसिकली ये ग्राफ वही रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, ये पार्टिकल ए के लिए हो गया, ये पार्टिकल बी के लिए हो गया, ये पार्टिकल सी के लिए हो गया।
मतलब सर वो पहले से ही नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव साइड पे,
हां पहले पॉजिटिव साइड पे था और अभी रेस्ट पे है वो।
हां ओके,
अगर आप मोशन देखेगा तो तीनों पार्टिकल रेस्ट पे ही है, समझा?
यस
ओके,
यस सर।
सो वी कैन जस्ट राइट लाइक दिस, आप एक ग्राफ ड्रॉ करना है लाइक दिस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम एंड एक ग्राफ ग्राफ आप ओरिजिन में ड्रॉ करो और एक पॉजिटिव में ड्रॉ करो और एक नेगेटिव में ड्रॉ करो। Then we can write over here theta is equal to zero, so the value of velocity is equal to zero. Here also theta is equal to zero, that means velocity is equal to zero. Here also theta is equal to zero, so velocity is equal to zero. Then over here we can represent that it represents that particle. Over here we can write particle is
at rest.
Is at rest. Is at rest at origin. Origin पे rest पे है. And here you can say that particle is at rest, but it is having some positive with some negative
value.
With negative displacement.
Displacement.
Now over here you can write particle is at rest. But with some positive displacement. Particle is at rest, but with positive displacement.
Sir, can you give us some example of a particle at rest with positive displacement or negative displacement?
Yeah, अभी बोला ना बेटा, अगर आप इसको हमारा x-axis consider कर रहे हैं, ये origin है. एक पार्टिकल ए है वो ओरिजिन पे रेस्ट पे है और एक पार्टिकल बी है वो ओरिजिन से 10 मीटर राइट पे है, तो बी का डिस्प्लेसमेंट क्या है? प्लस 10 है बट रेस्ट पे है वो, समझा? और एक पार्टिकल मान लो सी है वो माइनस 10 में है, मतलब डिस्प्लेसमेंट वाइज माइनस ओरिजिन से 10 पीछे है बट वो उधर रेस्ट पे है
विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए ना.
हां, विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए, विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ओरिजिन. समझ में आया बेटा?
यस सर.
लिख दिया?
यस सर.
तो इसमें पार्टिकल ओरिजिन पे है, ठीक है, एंड बाकी सब केस में पार्टिकल इज हैविंग सम पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट, उसको आप लिख देना. नाउ विल गो फॉर नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ ग्राफ. तो ये तो आपको मालूम पड़ा कि इफ अ ग्राफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ है एंड इफ ग्राफ इज पैरेलल टू टाइम एक्सिस, it represents that particle is at rest. Okay, now we'll go for a straight line graph but which is not parallel to time axis. Manlo I'm just representing a displacement time graph, something like this. Bolo what it represents.
Uniform acceleration,
uniform velocity,
uniform acceleration,
uniform acceleration.
Again aap slope ko dekho aur kuch mat dekho.
Theta theta is positive.
Na, pehle dekhna hai ki theta velocity is theta positive hai, to
positive velocity.
Positive
velocity.
And velocity constant hai ki nahi?
Yes, sir.
Samjha?
Yes.
Now I'm just drawing another graph like this.
Sir, in this case, sorry to interrupt you. Acceleration is zero, right?
Acceleration is zero. If velocity constant means acceleration zero.
Acceleration is zero. Okay.
बोलो ये graph क्या represent कर रहा
है? Uniform velocity.
Uniform velocity, positive velocity.
Yeah, uniform positive velocity. अभी बोलो ये graph क्या represent कर रहा है? ग्राफ किधर ड्रॉ कर रहा है, इट इज नॉट मैटर. ठीक है, द ग्राफ कैन बी ऑन दी लाइक पॉजिटिव साइड ऑफ वाई एक्सिस, नेगेटिव साइड ऑफ वाई एक्सिस. But you need to observe the slope, okay?
Yes, sir.
So in all these situations, slope is positive. That means particle is moving with a constant positive velocity. Now, positive velocity ka meaning hai, particle is moving towards a positive direction. Matlab, if you normally we'll assume that towards right as positive. Iska meaning hai, all these graph represents that particle is moving with a constant velocity towards right. Okay? So, abhi jab tak humne positive bolega, tab right maan lo, negative to left maan lo. Okay? अभी बोलो ये तीनों ग्राफ में डिफरेंस क्या है? व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीस थ्री ग्राफ?
सर ओरिजिन का डिफरेंस है. फर्स्ट इज 0, सेकंड इज नेगेटिव एंड लास्ट इज पॉजिटिव.
ये तो फर्स्ट दिस वन इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम ओरिजिन. ये ऑलरेडी पॉजिटिव से स्टार्ट किया है और आगे जा रहा है. ये नेगेटिव से स्टार्ट किया है और जीरो मतलब ओरिजिन की तरफ आ रहा है. समझा?
यस सर.
रीड आउट.
नो सर.
ओके, so we can represent these graph. Let's say displacement time. Now we can draw this graph, these three graph. The first step mein ab aise ye likhna hai, sab jagah pe sab case ka slope angle likho. Over here you can write theta, this is theta, and this is also equal to theta. Then you need to write tan theta is positive because theta is less than 90. Tan theta positive means it represents velocity is positive.
Nathi lagarun.
So this represents that particle, all this graph represents that particle is moving with a constant positive velocity. So over here you can write particle is moving with uniform positive velocity. And over here, particle is starting from rest. Sorry, starting from origin. Over here also, we can write the same thing. Particle is moving with a uniform positive velocity, starting with some positive displacement. Particle is moving with uniform positive velocity and starting from positive displacement. And here we'll write the same thing, but starting from negative displacement. And write particle is moving with uniform positive velocity starting from negative displacement. अभी तीनों केस में अगर आप फिजिकली देखेगा तो बोलो बेटा
सर हाउ कैन अ बॉडी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम नेगेटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट
बेटा इसका मीनिंग गलत ना पहले हमने ए और बी और सी का बात किया था ए ओरिजिन कंसीडर किया ए ओरिजिन पे था एंड नेक्स्ट वन वाज बी व्हिच वाज एट अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ प्लस 10 एंड देयर इज अनदर पार्टिकल सी व्हिच वाज ऑलरेडी एट अ नेगेटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ माइनस 10 नाउ All these particles A, B, and C are moving towards right with a velocity v. Got it?
Yes.
So this will be the graph for A, starting from origin, moving towards right. Yes. This for the graph for B, starting from positive displacement, moving towards right. This for the graph for C, starting with some negative displacement, moving towards right.
Okay.
Got it?
Okay, sir.
मतलब left side से start करके right side पे जा रहा है. So if it is a graph in displacement time graph and if it is a straight line and making some angle, it represents that particle is moving with a constant positive velocity. Now we'll go for next type of graph. Let's say in displacement time graph, same displacement time graph. Assume that one graph is like this and another graph is like this. This is this graph A and this is for graph for particle B. Now below, what this graph A represents? What graph A represents?
So uniform velocity.
Uniform positive velocity. Yeah, what about graph B? What about graph B?
Sir, same. Uniform positive velocity.
Positive velocity. Now below, what is the difference between A and B?
Sir, B is faster than A.
B ka velocity
is very good. B ka velocity is aise zyada aur B is faster than A. Wo kaise pata chala?
Theta is less time is covering more distance.
Zyada. Yes, yes. No, no, aap theta dekhna beta. Distance wo sab mat dekhna. Theek hai? Graph ka analysis mein only theta. So, theta, let's say theta A is the angle for graph A and theta B is the angle for graph B. Now first we need to observe that theta A is less than 90 and theta B is also less than 90. That means velocity of A is positive, then velocity of B is also positive. Next we'll compare theta B or theta A mein kya relation hai. Theta B velocity is greater than theta A.
Yes sir.
That means tan theta B ka value is greater than that of tan theta A. Tan theta B represents velocity of B and tan theta A represents velocity of A. So we can say that velocity of B is greater than velocity of A. Samjha?
Yes, sir.
Start on this one.
Yes, sir. Done.
Okay.
That's the answer.
Yeah. हो गया
यस सर
यस सर
ओके आई विल गो फॉर नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ ग्राफ एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ let's say the shape of this graph is something like this. Bolo, what it represents?
Negative velocity.
Yeah.
Starting from positive displacement.
Yes, very good. And what it represents?
Negative velocity starting from origin.
That's very good. So over here you can say that this represents this angle theta is over here theta is greater than 90.
Yes.
So we can say that the value of tan theta is going to be a negative value. So over here velocity is basically negative. So velocity negative, you just imagine that particle is moving towards left. Okay, so all this graph represents that particle is moving with a constant negative velocity, and the first graph represents that particle was starting from origin. Second one represents that particle is starting with some positive displacement. That represents that particle started with some negative displacement. मतलब ये origin से start करके left में जा रहा है, ये right से start करके left में जा रहा है, ये left में से start करके left में जा रहा है. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Just
write on this one.
Sir, we can use only tan theta.
Yeah, slope is always tan theta, beta. Okay. Only tan theta.
Sir, and only displacement time graph will come.
No. Displacement time graph is there. Velocity time graph is there. Acceleration time graph is there. Ek bar displacement
time graph. No, sir, I'm asking in. Tomorrow's exam.
आप basically kinematics का topic और vectors का cross product मतलब जो product है ना उसके उधर तक ज़्यादा करके रखो.
Okay sir.
Sir कल है test या Monday को है?
Monday.
Sir, we were told tomorrow.
Tomorrow hai kya? Okay.
Sir, the possibility is that it can be tomorrow.
Okay, main ek bar sir se pooch sakta hu. Ready sir? Ab hai kya group mein?
Sir chale.
Okay. Ab wo group mein aapko confirm karega, theek hai?
Sir, in these negative velocities, the velocity is constant na, but
velocity is constant because theta is not increasing or decreasing. Theta negative okay. But constant.
Yes, sir.
So you can write what it represents. You can write particle is moving with negative velocity. Negative uniform velocity or negative velocity. Okay. And over here, this represents that particle is starting from origin. Over here, starting from negative displacement. बाकी सेम ही लिखना है एंड दिस रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम
डिस्प्लेसमेंट.
सर इन दिस पार्टिकल इज मूविंग विद कांस्टेंट नेगेटिव वेलोसिटी ना.
हां एवरी सिचुएशन में वही सेम ही है. इसमें भी सेम है, इसमें भी सेम है. वो कहां से स्टार्ट करता है वो अलग रहता है बस.
यस सर.
सर
बोलो बेटा.
In all the graph, we have to see only the slope of the graph.
Yes. Graph को only slope use करके observe करना है. अगर आप graph का position क्या है, कुछ लोग क्या करेगा कि उसको ऐसा देखेगा, हाँ particle पहले इधर था, अभी इधर चले गया, ऐसा देखे तो आपको answer नहीं मिलेगा. Okay.
Okay sir.
बहुत सारे parameter आप देखे confuse हो जाएगा. Only एक इसको देखना है slope बस. और कुछ चीज़ देखना ही नहीं है. Okay.
Yes sir.
बोलो बेटा.
So for tomorrow's CDF, for what things we should refer in physics?
Mainly vectors up to cross product.
Okay.
Entire vector, basic maths, entire vector. This way.
Or mains के लिए
same vectors और ये neat के लिए ये kinematics का part भी आएगा शायद.
Okay.
Actually cumulative में आएगा तो अभी तक जो भी पढ़ा है सब पढ़ना पड़ेगा. Okay. ठीक है तो we'll continue in next class. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Can you confirm
that tomorrow is exam or not?
Yeah,
Sunday.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.